In case I forget later, we have parked in Dory, row 401. No tram for me today. We're close enough, we can just walk it in. Greetings everyone, it's Ken. Welcome back to Theme Park Flavors, a vegan adventure where we explore some storytelling of theme parks and then sample some plant-based foods. Today's gonna be a little bit different. This will be a part one of a two-part series as I am about a week early to the start of the annual Flower and Garden Festival. But I came out here early just to kind of check things out, see what's already here, and to do a little deep dive, a little history into one of the best features of this festival, and that is topiaries. This year's topiaries look amazing already. I've seen some online. Can't wait to see them in person and take you along for this little adventure around World Showcase and EPCOT Center. But first, let's do a little history lesson on these topiaries. Now, Walt Disney himself loved the idea of the topiaries. We're going to talk about a guy named Bill Evans in a minute, but Bill Evans said that Walt Disney was so impressed when he went out to Europe and he saw these amazing topiaries. He said, I want those in Disneyland. But he recognized that some of these topiaries were 300 years old and it would take 20 years to grow something like that for display. And he said, there's no point in us waiting 20 years for that. So he and Bill Evans got together with the Disney Imagineers and they blew up an image, life size, built a steel skeleton, and then padded it with moss and greenery and things that you'll see in just a moment. But this adventure began back in 1963, where Walt Disney had probably two dozen or so in Anaheim, California, for Disneyland. Now, I talked about Bill Evans. Bill Evans was a chief designer for him. And how they met was an interesting story. Bill Evans was a landscaper by design. His dad was a horticulturalist. And he later met up with a guy named Jack Reeves. And Reeves and Evans came together and formed a new company or a new business where they were doing landscaping for high-end clients like Clark Gable, Elizabeth Taylor, and of course, Walt Disney. Walt Disney hired them to landscape his home. And the rest is history. They got together, talked about these topiaries, and that's why we have them here today. Pretty cool. And so the timeline for these topiaries we're gonna see today, they started early January with the steel skeleton and pad up the skeleton with moss and greenery and things to grow. So by mid-February, they're pretty much done. And then they can prune them and clean them up and get them all ready for display to the start of the festival, which happens here in about a week from now. But enough yapping, let's go check out some topiaries. I think I see Mickey and Minnie right over here. I mentioned earlier that this will be part one of a two-part series. The festival isn't open yet, so we can't explore any vegan options yet. But we will come back out and explore some vegan flavors at this year's festival. Looks like Chip and Dale enjoying a little picnic lunch. I like that roasted corn right there. And giant carrots. I love Encanto. I love this attention to detail. There's a barbell right there on her dress. Here we are in Norway. I'm sorry, Arendelle. See, I told you we were in Arendelle. Busy bees. And I love that the pandas are back. What's up, fellas? Here in Germany is Snow White and Dopey. I just wonder where the other dwarves are. Think they're running someplace? I don't know. Welcome to Italy. This one's a little off the beaten path. It's Lanny and the Tramp. Okay, I'm putting this on my radar for later on. I think they open up at 11 Spice Road Table out here in Morocco. They have three awesome looking options for plant-based eaters. House-made hummus fries, citrus chipotle and preserved lemon for $10. This sounds yummy. Pomegranate chili crispy cauliflower, red pepper Aleppo sauce for $11. Or dolmas, grape leaves filled with rice and herbs, marinated olives and charred lemon for $9. And you can tell they're plant-based by this little icon right here, which means it is made without animal meat, dairy, eggs, and honey. And right before you get to France, come by and say hey to Miss Piggy and Kermit the Frog. Like Miss Piggy packed a lot of luggage for this trip. What's up, Kermie? So here in France, unless she moved, we should see some familiar faces around the corner. I love that his pendulum is swinging. Pretty clever. And the two hands on his face resemble a mustache. But you know where these two are. Belle and the Beast are not far behind. And Tinkerbell has to be the smallest topiary I've ever seen. Hey, Tink. Obviously, we're in England. Which means, if we timed it right, the Rose and Crown should be open. As much as I'm getting a little hungry, all this walking and making me very thirsty and all this talking, so let's head inside and get a drink. You in? Here we have Eeyore, Piglet, and Tigger. Right next to them is Winnie the Pooh and Rabbit too. I wonder what he's looking at. These two. And just like that, we're back where we started with Encanto right behind us. I'm hoping there are more topiaries to come out because I was told there was gonna be a very cool Bruno topiary this year. But then, we don't talk about Bruno. But spoiler alert, yes we do. Hoping he makes an appearance. Maybe he's just running a little bit late. Anyway, I have one more topiary to share with you. Then I gotta make up my mind where I'm gonna get something to eat. Here's a lovely little family of Disney ducks taking a stroll. It's Goofy. He looks like he's making a wish, blowing on that dandelion. Wonder what he's wishing for. What would you wish for? Behind me is the Odyssey. They always have fun offerings at the festivals. This year's festival offering for the Flower and Garden Festival is something called Citrus Blossom, featuring the Orange Bird. And if you know me, I love the Orange Bird. Definitely a checkout when we come back next time. So in the interest of science, and because I'm getting really hungry, we're gonna walk all the way back to Morocco. I don't typically walk back to a place I've already been to. And that crispy cauliflower, once I saw that, couldn't stop thinking about it. So I'll meet you guys there. A table on the water, sitting outside. Oh yeah. So there is another item on the menu not posted outside. It's at the very top here. It looks like tagine. Maybe saying that wrong. Seasoned vegetables, spiced chickpea stew, and herb couscous for $13. I just ordered the cauliflower and tamales. We'll see. And here's what we're dealing with. There's the cauliflower. There's a domas. There's my casa beer. And I'm gonna eat this and we'll talk about it when I get outside because it's kind of noisy in here and I'm hungry. So I'll meet you back outside when I'm all done and we'll chat. So over there, across the water, is Morocco. We just had lunch at the Spice Road table. And holy moly, one of the best meals I've ever had here at EPCOT. Let's begin with the cauliflower, the star of that meal. Holy moly. When they advertise crispy cauliflower, they deliver. The batter was super crispy, super crunchy, and it didn't get too soggy when they added that pomegranate syrup. It took a while for it to kind of soak in, but I think the batter was a little bit sweet as well, almost like an elephant ear batter. So you had the sweetness of the pomegranate syrup with little pomegranate seeds in it, and the batter balanced out well with that red pepper savoriness underneath and the cauliflower, which was not overcooked. I love that. The cauliflower was still crunchy. I had to use a knife to cut it instead of my fork. So a really nice, crunchy, delicious. I can't say enough about it, right? Now, I did order well, by accident, I think. Purely by accident, because I ordered the things that I knew I was gonna like. Now, I grew up Greek, and we called the Greek leaves domatas. They call them domas, tomato, tomato, right? Domas, domatas, whatever. It's all the same thing. But those were really, really good. They were soft and great flavor. The best part of that was this lemon that they charred, right? They just put it on the fire. You squeeze it over and it gives it that bright burst of citrus. And the olives were great because it was a good balance to the sweetness of the cauliflower. So you had sweet versus salty, you had crunchy versus soft, and you had that burst of lemon. Very well prepared, a little on the spot luncheon for me, and hopefully you'll enjoy it as well next time we're out here at EPCOT. Go visit, sorry, I'm being distracted by birds. What's up, buddy? Anywho, I'm gonna head out real quick, but before we do that, if you know me, we have one more stop to make, and that's gonna bring us to Joffrey's. Thank you for watching today's video. I appreciate your time and attention. If you took time out of your day to watch my video, thank you. Feel free to like, share, and subscribe. All those things are free to do so. But definitely subscribe if you like this kind of content. We're gonna come back later in the season. By the way, I wanna see something pretty cool. There's Spaceship Earth. We just walked from there. Here's my dory, 402. I think I may have mentioned 401 earlier, but it doesn't matter. There's my car right there. Look at that, right there. Look how close I am to the walkway. Love that. See ya. Bye.